ready to match the stars. Noel Ferrier. Colleen Brown. Joe Martin. Gloria Dawn. Stuart Weinstock. And John English. As we play, Graham Kennedy is Blankety Blanks. And now, here he is in person, Graham Kennedy.
We have a first. We're starting off without a full compliment. Where's John English? John. He's late again. John!
Oh, good job.
What's all that?
I've just been up the pub, mate. That's
all. No, listen, tell me about...
It's the cover.
That's right. It's the cover of the new album.
It's awesome. The cover on John's new album, which is called...
Minutes to Midnight.
Minutes to Midnight. You look splendid.
Thank you, guys.
Sit down.
He's masquerading as a virgin. That's what he's doing. And all that weight, yes.
Good evening to you all.
Hello.
Good evening, Ray.
Lovely to see you. Really lovely. And John English looking all beautiful. Where did we get? We didn't get to say who is playing tonight. That's where we got. We have Stephen Pastors, still our champion, but only with $100, and Kay Broadbridge. So we must see, this little board is very clever. It tells me certain things. It tells me it was very badly made. It tells me that we must have completed question one in round one. So this is question two for you, Stephen. Before the operation, Dr. Newman couldn't find his surgical mask, so he wore a blank over his head. What? Before the operation, Dr. Newman couldn't find his surgical mask, so he wore a blank over his head. Boing, da doing, boing. What would he have worn over his head?
I want to change. Can I?
Not if you're locked in, Noel. You can't change it. Everyone's in. Before the operation, Dr. Newman, whoever he is, couldn't find his surgical... Wouldn't it be funny if there's a Dr. Newman in the telephone directory and he seizes? Before the operation, Dr. Newman couldn't find his surgical mask, so he wore a what over his face?
A gown.
Oh, he put the gown over his... What do you think? They didn't like that. Noel.
Stephen, lad. No.
Stephen Pastors.
Oh, did I say? What about a bag?
Or a bag over his head. Paper bag. Now, there is a lovely old story to do with the paper bag. It's far too long to tell.
I remember it too.
I was the one.
Were you? In the barrel?
In the paper bag. What have you got, Noel?
I haven't got paper bag.
What have you got?
And I haven't got that.
Gown.
I've got panty.
Put panty over his head. Over his face.
Mm-hmm.
How peculiar. Johnny Martin.
Well, nothing like that. I thought medical. A Band-Aid.
A Band-Aid is funny. Band-Aid's funny. Glory.
Known as Big Mouth.
Gloria.
I put the most obvious answer, of course.
A stocking over his head. Yeah. And then he went and held up a bank.
That's right.
A stocking.
Stocking, yes.
Mr. White Tie and Tails.
No, I put a sack.
A sack over his head. I think we'll go straight into round... No, we won't. Tony the moustache twirler has indicated to me that we should pause here for station identification. Kay.
B, please.
B. B. Hey, did you hear that Fred got separated? It was horrible. His wife separated his blank from his head. Did you hear what? Fred got separated. Did you hear that Fred got separated? It was horrible. His wife separated his blank from his head. Hello, camera one. Oh, goodbye, camera one. We must put words to that. How's your big leg? Right in your face. Up on your nose. Oh. Hey, did you hear that Fred got separated? It was horrible. His wife separated his blank from his head.
Scalp?
His scalp! She was a red Indian lady, wife, girl, woman, Sheila, feminine lady.
Squaw.
Squaw. Squaw. Didn't like that. No. I don't know about that.
It'd be a squaw, wouldn't it, with the queen in town?
Well, there was nothing to keep his wig warm.
But will you agree to this? I mean, will that person agree to this?
Which person?
That person.
Here.
Yeah.
Reluctantly. Good on you for talking. Very reluctantly. No, he should talk. Nolene, did you hear what happened to Fred? His head.
It really was a parting.
Oh, it was. It really was.
There's another one.
Oh, it's a match. Joe, did you think along that line?
No, I thought along another one about a fellow who was completely, well, not completely bald, like Tony.
That's his...
Used to comb his hair in a circle.
Did he?
Mm.
Yeah.
I put body.
Separated his body from his head. Of course, that'd be worse because then you'd have him in two portions.
Ooh.
What'd you
Which
put?
One would... Oh,
yes,
here
the
we
part
are.
That has
yeah,
the...
Mm. Look at that.
The body, yeah. Mm. I would have thought that more Ditto. Than hair. Body?
Mm-hmm.
Sorry.
Body. Oh, blimey. Here we go. The last part of round two, and this is where we usually eliminate someone. Although I like these two, I don't... If it was up to me, we wouldn't eliminate anyone. And, Stephen, you need three to win. So you need three matches. And as I see it, everybody plays. Knock. No, not knock. Enoch. Enoch the Eskimo said, it's tough living in an igloo. Not only are the walls made out of ice, but inside, even the blank is made out of ice. You know? Enoch the Eskimo said it's tough living in an igloo. Not only are the walls made out of ice, but inside, even the blank is made out of ice. Do you know how to make an igloo? You get 400 pounds of egg and then you glue it together. We have two camera threes tonight, which I think is fascinating. Everyone's in. Enoch the Eskimo said, it's tough living in an igloo. Not only the walls made out of ice, but inside, even the blank is made out of ice.
His bed.
His bed. Oh, I would have.
Oh, not again.
Oh, didn't go over well, Stephen.
Don't you worry, Stephen.
Hello?
Don't you worry at all.
Oh! A match. How can you make a bed out of ice?
Quite easily, with a pick.
I'll just make your bed.
I
didn't think that would ever happen. Nolene, my love, you didn't have a bed.
No. I didn't, and the worst place I can think of to sit in the cold is on the dunny.
On the dunny! I would have thought... Of course, you know me and my history. I would have thought that too.
Well, I was going to put dunny, but I didn't know how to spell it, so I put toilet.
Toilet's nice. It's nice. You're allowed to put dunny or lavatory.
Well, I'm here to tell you I've got the most obvious answer.
Oh. Bed! Whoa! I smell a Tide game coming on. Stuart, get me out of this. You know how I love Tide games.
I wish I could, Graham.
No
but
bed.
I've got the toilet seat.
Toilet seat, yes.
Yes.
Make John, it's smart. Up to you, or else we have a Tide game. Now, I plug the album. I let you wear white on the show. The CCU boys don't like it.
Can I change my answer?
We should change your clothes.
Oh.
No.
I put Kazi, which is same thing.
Oh, really? What? Kazi?
Toilet, yeah.
No, I didn't know that.
Didn't you?
Who calls the dunny a Kazi?
The English.
Oh, do they?
Yes. Yeah.
Mm. I didn't know that.
Well, it's like Dunny.
Well, when I've been over there...
Carol should be here.
Carol, say Kazi.
No, Kazi.
I don't
think
Kazi.
She said the twink.
Twink.
Oh, she said twink.
I didn't know that. I've been over there and no one's... When I've said, could you tell me... I walk up and I say, excuse me, where's the dunny? And they always know to say... They never call it that. No. We have a tied game, which is played like any other game. We're not going to play it yet because I think I'm going home. We're going to have a tied game now. Tied game's played like any other game. Most wins, A or B?
B, please.
B. The condemned man said... I rather like
it. That's good, yes, yes.
The condemned man said, my wife is wonderful. Tomorrow I'm being executed. So she's knitted me a blank. Touch of mother courage, I thought, Gloria.
Beautifully done.
The condemned man said, my wife is bloody wonderful. Tomorrow I'm being executed, so she's knitted me a blank.
I wish I could change
it. Boing, ba-doing, boing. It's so hot tonight. It's hot, Channel 10. Oh, yes, it is. France's fame, gay, gay, gay. Is there another? Oh, they finished. The condemned man said, my wife is wonderful. Tomorrow I'm being executed, so she's knitted me a blank.
Bag for his head?
A bag for his head. She's knitted him blank. A bag for his head. Yes, I hope he's not being. Well, I don't. It doesn't say how he's being executed, but. Quite often they do cover their head for very obvious reasons.
Well, they do. That's the most extraordinary thing to ask.
What? Stuart?
Stuart's
been... Stop it!
No, did you hear what he said?
Well, I'm trying not to. Shame, Stuart.
Shame.
I want to see you in the dressing room afterwards. In fact, we both do.
Yes, we do.
All right.
We're having a ménage à trois. No, that's how we leave it in, they wouldn't understand that. Hello, now.
What about Jumper?
Oh. Why?
Why not?
knitted me a jumper, yes. You don't have to use, you wouldn't have to use a thick ply, would you? Only going to wear it the once.
I was trying to get him out of this awful predicament, but I couldn't, so she was just knitting him a shroud.
Oh. Oh, it's brought a nasty taste to the mouth. Joe. This is a rather kicky question.
I know. I didn't have enough room to put A. Reuben, F, so I just put scarf.
Knitted him a scarf. Mm. If I buy the wool, will you knit me one too? Gloria.
Well, why shouldn't he look nice?
Lovely scarf to go to your death in.
Thank you, Gloria.
Lovely bright colours.
And perhaps you could do it with the scarf, couldn't you?
Yeah, smart. Like knitted a noose.
Right.
No, that is the end of the noose.
new snippet.
Thank you. People have a great taste in discrimination out there.
Revolting.
Yes, not as revolting as my first answer.
No.
I don't think I like that answer,
Stuart. Don't even talk to him. No. Don't associate. No,
that's a bit too close.
Try not to have the same dressing room. None of us want to.
That's right. Yes
that's too close to home.
Yes, because as Judas, when John English was Judas every night in Jesus Christ Superstar.
I decided not to put anything tasteless like that. I think she knitted him a coffin.
He was hanged every night. Knitted him a coffin. Oh, now you would have to use a thick skein there, wouldn't you? Oh, I didn't like that one. Every now and then we get one of those and I'm not really thrilled. No robber will ever rob Horrible Hannah because Horrible Hannah keeps all her money in her blank. And she's really horrible. She's really horrible, this Hannah. This is not a reference to anyone called Hannah out in television land. No robber will ever rob Horrible Hannah because Horrible Hannah keeps all her money in her blank. Yes. Yes, no one would touch her. Boing, boing. Now, do you realise, Stephen, you've only got to get one to win the entire thing? No robber will ever rob Horrible Hannah because Horrible Hannah keeps all her money in her
pants.
I see her getting out of a taxi and saying, just a minute. Yes, I've got change. Horrible.
Where does the Sheilas keep their money?
Oh, well, my aunt keeps it in the top of her stocking because it draws more interest that way.
Body. Well, I'm agreeing with the other.
Knickers his pants! So, everybody hold up your answer. Drawers, trapdoors, bra, drawers. Oh, you would have won anyway. Come up, Stephen. Kay, you know how Don Blake often talks about the delights in the Toshiba range? You're getting one of those. Thank you for playing Blankety Blanks. Good night. And don't forget to write. Okay. Off goes Kay. Goodbye. We've played Supermatch how many times?
Five.
Why have you only got $100?
I'm a bit lousy.
So you're not coming up with the right... No. You're not picking the right... We'll see how you do this time. First, it's revenue time. We have a little selling to do. We polled a recent studio audience and discovered their most frequent response to this. Look. What does it say?
Affair.
Oh, blank affair. Yes. Oh, I'm thinking of the opposition. Well, now, listen, if you by some chance
just happen to select the one they gave, the answer they gave most often, you get $100. Now, if you by chance fail that and perchance get the $50 response, you get $50. So I should never change it. I should never change it. And if you match their third most frequent response, you get $25. Now, over here, you mightn't have realised this, but there are six celebrities there. I've had a good look. I can't find any. That's me being silly. They're all celebrities. Now, who would you like to help you?
Stuart Wagstaff.
Stuart Wagstaff is a celebrity.
Love affair.
Love affair. Romantic old Stuart. Noel Ferrier? Noel Ferrier is a celebrity.
Dare I say, current.
Current. And he said it in the style of Frank Thring, didn't he?
Oh, yes.
Yes, current affair, you little pixie piece.
Joe Martin.
Joe Martin.
Family.
Is a celebrity.
Who?
Family Affair.
Family Affair. Wonderful television program. Current Affair, Love Affair, Family Affair. I don't know. I can't help you. You must decide. You don't have to choose one of those. You might think they're all terrible. In which case, come up with your own idea.
Current Affair.
Current Affair. We'll find out, as usual. We'll start at the bottom and ask Peter the Phantom Puller to have a pull. Thanks, Peter. Family Affair. Let's see what's under the $50 response. Thank you, Peter. That's where it was. That's where it was. Well, what could have been up there? Thank you, Peter. Love Affair. You've won $50. Now you play for 5, 10 times that amount. $5,000. $500. I forget how to play the game. You have won $50. You play now for 10 times that amount. $500. Now, who do you select? Because this is spot on. There can be no fiddling around. There's no thumbs up or thumbs down. It's got to be exact.
Noel Ferrier, please.
Oh. Just ruined Noel's evening.
I never get to play a super match, you know.
Oh, don't.
It's
is this your first one?
For me.
Is this your first.
Well, for a long time.
Oh, good. All right. Yes, just turn around and face me so you can't see what Noel writes. Children. Attention. Day of the blank. D-A-Y-O-F. D-A-Y-O-F-T-H-E.
Day of the what?
Day of the blank.
Oh, what?
No. Now that he's got the chance to play it, he doesn't know how to play it. Day of the blank.
Oh, won't come off.
Don't tell us your problem.
That's right.
Day of the blank.
No, I don't think so either. Yeah, that's right.
Noel's in trouble.
Wait a minute, I'm right now. Be quiet.
You're in trouble. Oh, we can always wait for you. Day of the...
Jackal.
Oh, that's good. No, that's good. Yeah. I thought Day of the Jackal or Day of the Triffids.
Yeah, well, it's a bit of a toss-up, isn't it?
It is a bit of a toss-up. This is for $500,
and
Noel.
Mainly because... I don't know how to spell Triffin. I put
Day of the Jackal! Oh! Congratulations, Steve. Go and shake his hand. I thought we'd... Listen, stop it. Thank you. Oh, why'd you do that? I didn't... I just looked at my watch and nearly... had an accident. Time to say good night from Blankety Blank. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night, Joe.
Good night, Joe.
Good night.
All prices are moved by Grace Brothers Removals, the professionals. Interstate artists, fly and set and dryer papers, the people who always say, we try harder. Whilst in Sydney, Graham Kennedy chooses to stay at the Boulevard Hotel, 90 William Street, King's Cross. It's a Reg Grundy production, produced in colour at the studios of Channel 10 Sydney in association with the O10 Network. Don Blake speaking.